dilated cardiomyopathy. Towards the end of this video, you'll be able to learn the introduction, the etiology, the pathophysiology, the clinical features, the gross and microscopic findings, the diagnosis, and the treatment of dilated cardiomyopathy. Dilated cardiomyopathy, otherwise termed as congestive cardiomyopathy, represents a range of myocardial disorders characterized by left and right ventricular dilation and reduced myocardial contractility. There will be a progressive dilation of all the chambers of the heart, causing a reduction in the contractility, resulting in heart failure due to systolic dysfunction. The systolic dysfunction is characterized by a reduction in the ejection fraction. Dilated cardiomyopathy is characterized by global enlargement of the heart, which is visible on imaging. The etiology of dilated cardiomyopathy can be memorized by a mnemonic, I am mad, my pump failed, where I stands for idiopathic, which is the most common cause. M stands for myocarditis, which can be secondary to Coxsackie type B virus or myocarditis, as in Chagas disease, which can be caused by Trypanosoma cruzi infection. A stands for alcohol, where excessive alcohol consumption leads to acetaldehyde metabolite toxicity and or thiamine deficiency. D stands for drugs, especially cocaine. M stands for medication, especially doxorubicin and daunorubicin. Where P stands for pregnancy, pregnant women can have peripartum dilated cardiomyopathy, which is defined as dilated cardiomyopathy within 4 weeks before the delivery or 5 weeks after the delivery. F stands for familial inheritance, wherein there can be genetic mutations of cytoskeleton. Although the most common cause is idiopathic, some cases of dilated cardiomyopathy have been attributed to certain types of toxic injury by organic solvents. Hence, it is also called as glue sniffer's heart. The pathophysiology of dilated cardiomyopathy is initiated by poor contractility due to various etiological reasons, resulting in reduced stroke volume and ejection fraction, leading to a narrow pulse pressure and enlargement of the heart. Because of the ventricular dilation, they stretch out the valves separating the atria and ventricles, which in turn causes incomplete closure of the mitral and tricuspid valves during systole, leading to regurgitation of blood back into the atria, which causes mitral valve regurgitation on the left side and tricuspid regurgitation on the right side, producing holosystolic murmurs, which means a murmur that can be heard during the entire period of cardiac systole. In addition, we can also hear S3 sound, which is due to rapid rush of blood into the dilated ventricles during rapid filling phase of the cardiac cycle. Arrhythmias can be a complication of dilated cardiomyopathy due to the stretch of the myocardial fibers, which can disturb and irritate the cells of the conduction system. Most patients present between the ages of 20 and 60, but dilated cardiomyopathy can occur in children and older adults as well. The other clinical manifestations are that the patients have cardiomegaly, an ejection fraction which is less than 40%. In patients having dilated cardiomyopathy, they present with signs and symptoms of both right and left heart failure, where fatigue, edema, ascites, pleural effusion, and raised jugular venous pressure are the features of right heart failure, where exertional dyspnea or orthopnea and paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea are features of left heart failure. S3 is highly specific for dilated cardiomyopathy. There can be mitral and tricuspid valve regurgitation, along with bundle branch blocks leading to atrial and ventricular arrhythmias. Dilated cardiomyopathy is diagnosed by imaging modalities like chest x-ray and echocardiogram. On chest x-ray, dilated water bottle shaped heart and pleural effusion can also be seen. Curly type B lines can also be seen if pulmonary edema is present. Echocardiogram demonstrates dilated ventricular walls. Microscopic findings of dilated cardiomyopathy in this slide, which is shown right here, includes myocyte hypertrophy with collagen in blue color stain. Gross findings demonstrate four-chamber dilation along with mural thrombosis, which are frequently associated with dilated cardiomyopathy, which can be seen at the apex of the ventricle. Imaging. Cardiac MRI without contrast demonstrates markedly dilated left ventricle with thinned myocardium. On a posterior anterior view of the chest X-ray, it demonstrates an enlarged heart in patients with known dilated cardiomyopathy. Therapy is directed at treating fluid overload, maintaining a cardiac output, reversing the underlying cause when possible, and preventing disease progression and complications. Guideline-directed medical device therapies including implantable cardioverter defibrillator and cardiac resynchronization therapy supplement the medical treatment of dilated cardiomyopathy. Medical treatment is similar to management of congestive heart failure with salt and water-restricted diet, diuretics, angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors, beta blockers, vasodilators to reduce preload and afterload. Dilated cardiomyopathy is the most frequent indication for cardiac transplantation. In patients receiving potentially cardiotoxic cancer therapy, the oncologist should consider switching to a different chemotherapeutic agent.